As of August 17th of 2025, there are currently 44 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet, a total which is one less than were erupting last week. One of these, which is the only volcanic complex to be actively erupting in Alaska, is its remote Great Sitkin volcano. Located in the Aleutian Islands, 26 miles east-northeast of the nearest populated settlement, the Great Sitkin volcano is currently undergoing its single longest eruption on record, which has been ongoing for 1,545 days, or 4.23 years. In this time span, a very large basaltic andesite lava dome has not only filled the western two-thirds of its summit caldera, but also spilled over and flowed downslope by as much as 3,600 feet. This eruption could continue for multiple more years. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In Russia, lava flows continued to expand at two stratovolcanoes, and right when it appeared that Klyuchevskoye's highly explosive eruption had ended, it suddenly reactivated after an 8-hour-long pause. Meanwhile, in Ecuador, a moderate magnitude earthquake struck in close proximity to the Cotopaxi volcano, which could, in theory, be linked to some form of volcanic unrest. And, in what is this week's top story, it appears that Indonesia's Lewotobi volcano might soon produce another major explosive eruption. I say another major eruption because since November of last year, this stratovolcano on the island of Flores has been seemingly locked into a fairly predictable cycle that culminates in a major eruption occurring. In the 287 days since this cyclical activity began, 7 major eruptions have occurred, which have resulted in the following. Damage or destruction of approximately 2,400 structures, 13 fatalities, a combined area of 89.46 square kilometers or 34.5 square miles was incinerated by pyrocaustic flows, up to car-sized lava bombs that formed impact craters when they landed as much as 11 kilometers away, and regional air traffic disruptions as far away as Bali. To put it bluntly, Lewotobi's Leki Leki cone has the potential to increase multiple of the aforementioned statistics if and when it does produce another major eruption. In the last 5 days, the ground deformation at Lewotobi's edifice has dramatically increased. An increased volume of magma is actively rising or is soon to rise through its magma conduit, with this potentially occurring at about the same time that the basaltic andesite lava dome becomes large enough that it forms a plug. While this is highly speculative, in my opinion, such a major eruption seems to have a moderate chance of occurring in the next week, with a high likelihood of it happening before the end of the month. After all, the last 3 major Lewotobi eruptions occurred a mere 20 to 25 days apart from one another. Meanwhile, in Russia, fresh lava fields at 2 erupting volcanoes expanded, but at the same time, these volcanoes saw their eruptions both decline in intensity. For example, today marks day 16 of Krasheninnikov's first eruption in more than 500 years, but while it is still erupting, its ash emissions are becoming far less frequent. And when these ash emissions do occur, they are no longer reaching above 15,000 feet altitude. Lava effusion has also seemingly declined week over week, but that has not stopped a new third lobe of lava from flowing to the northeast, and its overall lava field growing from 1.57 square kilometers to covering 2.05 square kilometers. Heading 100 miles to the north, Klyuchevskoye's intense eruption continued during the early part of the week, creating ash emissions that drifted as far away as Alaska, causing flight cancellations at the town of Nome. Then, after 2 weeks of intense strong ash emissions, Klyuchevskoye's eruption abruptly stopped, only to resume 8 hours later at a much weaker intensity, continuing ever since. Despite the continuation, its lava field has ceased expanding, having reached a size of 1.79 square kilometers. And in Ecuador, a magnitude 4.8 earthquake struck 10 kilometers or 6 miles northeast of the Cotopaxi volcano on August 16th and was followed by more than 50 aftershocks. While this is probably just an ordinary tectonic earthquake sequence, its proximity to Cotopaxi means there is a chance it could be volcanic unrest related, so a close eye is being kept on this stratovolcano. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on August 16th of 2025. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member, John Green, for supporting my work.